So I know I've been adamantly against doing vlogs on the motorcycle. I actually haven't done one since about a year ago. At the time, it was pretty hard for me to concentrate and articulate words very well. To not put in filler or useless words. It's funny what you learn from motovlogging. I've been doing this for about a year and a half. About a year ago, I had 100 subscribers. I'd only been riding for about 3 months when I started motovlogging. And really, we'd only gone for weekend trips for like 2 hours usually. 2-3 hours. Because I was terrible at it. And I probably only had about 20 hours on the motorcycle when I started motovlogging. But yeah, I've been on a bike about maybe 450 hours. And I have recorded about 350 of those, 375. So somewhere around like 75% of what I've ridden. Plus all the time that I recorded for working on my bike, because I used to record every single time I worked on my bike, which amounted to something like 250 hours. Over the past year and a half, I've recorded about 9% of my life. Through this process of motovlogging, I have actually created quite a bit of a journal here. Like I actually can go and look back and like see myself improve and develop a whole bunch of skills and develop myself. Well, I used to keep a journal for years, but I kind of stopped after a little bit of motovlogging. And it's just that motovlogging always has this way of just kind of being the same thing in a lot of ways. It's the same things that I always wanted to tell, which was just things that I learned, things that I saw. But I've only ever talked about motovlogging back when I had about 100 subscribers, and I haven't talked about it because this isn't very useful. Even though there are a lot of motovloggers in the world, there are so many. I mean, here in Colorado, active motovloggers, there's about 30. Inactive, there's about 60. So in the United States, you can safely argue that there's about 8,000 motovloggers, I'd say. I mean, go and search motovlogger on YouTube, and you'd have 10,000 channels show up. So a year and a half ago, about, I think it was September? Yeah, September 2014, my brother suggested that I should do motovlogs. I'd never seen one. You know, I'd seen a couple of the trail vids that he showed me. I looked up, you know, like search for trails before he rode on them. That's all I saw, you know, soundless, audioless. Sometimes they'd have music. But, you know, just like poorly or uncut videos. And that really dominates the off-road video scenario because, again, people get GoPros and they just want to post their videos and they kind of expect attention. But yeah, I decided to do it, and I watched a couple of the bigger guys to try to see how they did it and how I might be able to do it well. So other than that, I've only ever really watched people who watched me. And that's not like a, you know, tit for tat kind of thing. It's just that God, I watch so much. I mean, when you do this as much as I have for a year and a half, it's just I've gotten to the point where it's just like I watch so much motorcycle footage. You develop a very personal relationship with a lot of people, and you kind of think about it, and I have a good 30, 40 people who will comment on every single video that I have. Most are motovloggers, because, you know, I guess normal people don't really comment. They'll say, you know, something about their life, and they're like, oh yeah, that looked hard. You know, I bet I could do better. But I bet I could do it, you know, kind of thing. And then you watch their stuff, and, you know, you have this whole, like, interchange, and you come to get to know people. You come to get to know people really well that you've never met. It's weird. If you guys don't know Adventures in Real Life, you should check him out. He does some really good videos. The guy breaks everything down into like a science. He makes, you know, he's got that engineering mind.
Adventures in Real Life proved that shit wrong. Dude, that dude, you ever see his stuff? He don't give a shit. He's riding year round. I want to go out there just to ride with Adventures in Real Life. He does some crazy shit. Like they're out in the middle of nowhere running out of gas and crap.
That's going to be Adventures in Real Life. The guy is awesome.
So first shout out is to Adventures in Real Life, or ARL.
What about my main man, Adventures in Real Life? Name is just too damn long to say. How many syllables? Adventures in Real Life. A six-syllable name, that's hard to say. I just say Adventures. Even that's too long. It's like three syllables.
Another vlogger I've been talking a lot to is Adventures in Real Life. Another really good guy.
Again, a big thank you to Adventures in Real Life.
Adventures in Real Life. Go and check him out. He is an awesome dude, and he does have adventures in real life. He's more of an adventurer than I am, that's for sure.
Motovlogging always pushes me to try harder.
to do better, to go further. It's like it's an accountability system. You know, it's saying that we want you to do better. You know, you have this world where it says we want you to do better. Where the consequences for not succeeding are just that nobody cares. There are really no negative consequences to failing at motovlogging. You just, nobody cares. But the positive consequences that you might do something impressive enough that somebody might care. I mean, you know, not that that should be really your motivation, but I mean, you have a really good feedback, a really good positive feedback for improving yourself and your skills as a person. I am a very good writer now, apparently. I mean, I'm not a very good writer, but I am definitely above average. In only a year and a half, I've surprised pretty much everyone I've ridden with. But to go further, to try to get something else, you know, I'm happy. I could wander around Colorado for probably 2 or 3 years and never see the same thing. But yeah, you know, going further is better. It's more challenging, and I enjoy challenges. And I don't have to win at all of them, but I'm good at figuring them out in the long run. So, see if I figure out this one. One of the things that really sold me on the adventure riding community was the people. I mean, there are a few bad eggs, but most of them I would call exceptional. It's amazing to me, knowing no matter where I go, I'll probably have somebody close by who wants to go for a ride. That I never have to be alone, unless I want to be. I have so many people who are willing to help me out, or like, I say I want to go somewhere, and they're like, yeah, I could tell you about all these places. Or, you know, offer me a place to stay. It's like, that's kind of surprising and weird. I mean, that's kind of surprising. I mean, amazing to me. To think that just people I've never met would invite me into their home. But I guess they know me. A little. So I wanted to show my appreciation. It's amazing to me that 1,000 people have decided that I'm worth paying attention to. I mean, that's a lot of people. That's so... I don't know if I've met 1,000 people. So I've made a few things. I've made some t-shirts. I made quite a few designs, and I came up with two that I really liked, that I felt turned out really well. So there's one's kind of black, one's kind of white here, or cream color. And I might make more of those as time goes on, because this is something that's kind of enjoyable for me. I kind of like to make little artistic things. I've seen more of the world in the past year and a half than I've seen in my entire life previous. I'm amazed at all the things I've had the chance to discover, the places I've seen of the parts of the world that I didn't know. It's really been something. So for who all those people I've met and everything else, you have my thanks. For all the skills I've learned and all the wonderful things I've come to know, I am my thanks for that. I hope that I can continue this and see more and maybe get a little bit further. There's so much of the world that you have to discover. That there is to discover, and that people aren't aware of. That I'm not aware of. I've always thought of adventure riding as a bit of a conservationist effort. I mean, maybe just adventure motovlogging. Because we go out and we see a little bit of the world. And we find stories about what happened there, why it is that way. And then we take the time to make something out of it, to try to tell others, to say, this is worth my time to preserve this history.